What's going on, everybody? Ninetales Commander here, and welcome to episode 65. I was about to say 55, but that episode has come and gone. 65, Pokemon Battle Zone. Here we go. They lead off with a Seismitoad. Awesome. I love Seismitoad. Just a shame I've got to take it out with my here Shaymin with Seed Flare. That looks really cool in this game. I mean, the Seed Flare looks awesome. Come to think of it, a lot of the moves look really good in these games. Especially Flamethrower and Fire Blast. You know, Draco Meteor. Some of the moves just look amazing for a handheld game. So, I'm going to switch out now and bring in my Blastoise. Why am I bringing in a Blastoise? NC, you were a bit of a pleb on this. Because, yeah, I know he could have gone for Charizard X, but if he's Charizard Y, which he is, well, that basically means he can just Solar Beam you and take you out. It doesn't matter if you are a fire type. A water type. Solar Beam's gonna kill you, bro. I kinda goofed on this part. So, I guess I'm just going to take a Solar Beam right to the face. Maybe it was intentional, I don't know. Then again, Daybreak sure has hit. Man. Yeah, maybe I should send out Mistress to help out. Anyway, so I'm gonna bring in Gardevoir here. And now I'm going to Mega Evolve into Mega Gardevoir and Fat Gardevoir. Seriously, she looks like she put on so much weight. I know she's not actually fat, but she looks so fat in that form. So he's going to go for Flamethrower, and I'm now going to go for Thunderbolt. That's probably going to KO. Dang it, it's not. But it doesn't matter, because in natural Mega Evolution terms, Gardevoir is faster than Charizard. So it doesn't matter if Thunderbolt did not KO. Well, anyway, so I'm going to bring in Greninja now. Okay. And he's going to go for Ice Beam, and yeah, this is not going to be nice. This is probably going to kill me. Yep, it is going to kill me. Because, you know, 21 HP. And Greninja's pretty strong on offense. Good thing the sunlight faded. Well, actually, isn't a good thing, because, well, sunlight wasn't really beneficial to any of us. In fact, come to think of it, why do you have a water Pokemon on a team that has a Charizard with Draught on it? Not a good idea, buddy. So, of course, there's no way a Seaflare is not going to one it KO Greninja. So, yay, we defeated another one. We defeated Steven in his own universe. If you get that joke. I know some people will. So, I'm going to go ahead and start off with my Jolteon. No point mentioning it again. So, he's going to lead off with Krugodile. Crud. That's not good. I'm going to lose my Krugodile right away. That sucks. So, that means he's going to get a Moxie boost. Great. So, I'm going to bring in my Salamence, because the good news is since he outsped me, I now know that he is Choice Scarfed, which means he has to switch out. Unless, of course, he just wants to sit there and spam Earthquake and see it do absolutely nothing, which, of course, he's not going to do. So, he's going to go out into a Pokemon that I actually did not see because I was too busy talking. Oh, it's a Blastoise. Huh. I just used one of those. So, I'm going to Mega Evolve into the Croissant, and I'm going to start advertising with Hyper Voice once again, and that's going to result in a 2-hit KO, just like with the other Blastoise that I was using. That's pretty funny. So, he's going to lead off with Gengar? Okay. I mean, no Mega Evolution? I mean, well, okay. Whatever works, buddy. So, he's going to go ahead and take that, apparently. I'm actually surprised he managed to live the Draco Meteor, to be honest. Good thing I was able to take his Dazzling Gleam. And now he chooses to Mega Evolve. Why did you hold off on Mega Evolving? I mean, seriously. Why? Why did you hold off on the Mega Evolution? I mean, it doesn't really matter because, you know, I'm just going to KO you with Hyper Voice anyway. So, why did... You know, if you'd have Mega Evolved, you probably would have taken me out. Well, maybe. Maybe not. I don't know. I mean, you probably would have. I mean, you are stronger offensively. But, of course, now he's just going to bring in his Scarfed Krugodile, which means all I've got left is whatever Pokemon I have in the boot. And he's, of course, going to get a Moxie boost. So I bring in my Victini. That sucks. I mean, he has Dragon Claw, so... I can take it, actually. Actually, yeah, I can take it. So now I can just go straight in for a V-Create and please KO. Please KO Victini. Yes, it KO'd. Excellent. And that actually brings me to the victory. Excellent. So, as always, I will see you guys for the next episode. You know, if you have any Pokemon to request, you can leave them in the comments if you like. Bye.